now, it's been a dramatic night with the Supreme Court hearing a plea by the Congress against the swearing-in of B.S. Yeddyurappa as the Chief Minister of Karnataka this morning at 9. Finally, the decision by the Supreme Court was that it refused to stay the swearing-in of Yeddyurappa, but it keeps the entire case subject to the outcome of the hearing. This hearing, however, in this entire matter will continue. So B.S. Yeddyurappa can be sworn in as the Chief Minister, and the Supreme Court observed this during this rare post-midnight hearing that we've seen over 3.5 hours. And in the court for those 3.5 hours was NDTV's Vaidyanathan, where there are all kinds of issues were brought before the Supreme Court of utmost constitutional importance and significance about governors' decisions, whether the Supreme Court can interfere in governors' decisions, the Congress talking about defections and horse trading, and you had the AG even arguing that why was this hearing taking place, what was the crisis and why this hearing in the middle of the night. So take us through some of those key observations and of course the final decision. This case will continue, the next hearing will take place on Friday.
Before going into all of this, all these things started around 10:40 or so. We got the information that Congress is moving the Supreme Court. So around 11 o'clock, they filed the petition in Supreme Court registry. Then registrar normally goes through whether it needs an urgent hearing. Then around 11:45 or 11:50, took the petition to the Chief Justice resident. Then Chief Justice around 1 o'clock took the decision to constitute a 3-judge bench headed by Justice A.K. Sikri and other Justice Bobde as well as Ashok Bhushan, 3 judges. He said around 1:45 or 1:50 the hearing will start. So hearing started around 2:10 in court number 6. Then Attorney General came. He is around 90 years. He came around 3 o'clock in the morning, and Mukul Roti was there before the hearing. Abhishek Manuswingi and assisted by Devdutt Kamathu just spoke to us. All were there. So Abhishek Manuswingi started his arguments and went on for more than an hour. His basic points were, it's a simple arithmetic, 104 with BJP, 116 with JDS, Congress and BSP. Why not the governor go by the arithmetic? It's completely illegal for the part of the governor to invite Yeddyurappa. You should have invited Congress, JDS combined and Kumarasamy. And he said Supreme Court has earlier also went into the whole issue, and single largest party cannot only be invited. If the governor feels the combined post-poll alliance can give a majority, can give a stable government, they can be invited. He quoted few judgments. So after that, Attorney General said that heavens will not fall. Why should the court take up the case right now? Court can just defer the hearing later and go into it. But Abhishek Manuswingi was saying that court should stay the swearing in, and if not stay, at least defer it by 2 days or even 48 hours by the time court can examine the whole issue. But judges made it very clear saying that they can't stop the swearing in, but they can, after that, they can go into this issue whether the governor's actions legal or illegal. Mr. Mukul Rothiki, appearing from two advocates, told the court saying that court cannot summon the governor. Yes, discretionary powers, he can do anything, but whatever he does, right or wrong, he can do it, but his actions can be questioned by the court, but don't stop the swearing in. What is the need for the midnight hearing? He said the court only opened its doors midnight at 2 a.m., exactly 2 a.m. for Yaqub Maimon, because he was to be hanged next day morning, 6 a.m. So he said nothing much is going to happen, why the court should hear this case. But anyway, judges said, well, since Chief Justice has constituted, we are hearing the case. But finally, court said it wanted the two letters written by Yeddyurappa to the governors taking claim and his support. They wanted to examine that letter. And judges also made a comment saying that why this 15 days, quite long time. And the AG was saying it may be 7 days or 5 days, it's for a governor to decide. So anyway, court has said three things. Swearing in will go on today at 9 a.m. Court will not stay it or stop it, and even it can't defer it. And secondly, it said it issued notices to central government in Karnataka. And thirdly, it asked the Attorney General to produce the letters Yeddyurappa has written to the governor, two letters. So that will be produced tomorrow. Tomorrow, 10:30, the court will hear the case again. Probably it will dispose of tomorrow itself. So tomorrow, the 15 days long time given to Yeddyurappa may even be reduced by a few days, maybe 7 days or less than that. For that, we will have to wait till tomorrow. Gargi, back to you.
All right, Veda, so you're expecting that the case, the final hearing will be on Friday, that at 10:30 in the morning, and they have asked for those letters, as you said, and you expect that is when they'll give a decision?
Yes, court was saying we wanted to dispose of the case today itself because the letter was not there in the file, what exactly Yeddyurappa has written, what is the claim, how he is commanding the majority. All these things the judges want to see through the letter Yeddyurappa has written to the governor. That's why they summoned the letter. So tomorrow they might be disposing of the case, because they also said that all this, whatever happens, swearing in after that, all subject to the final decision. So they may dispose of the case, but I can't be sure. But at the same time, this 15 days long time may have probably may be curtailed tomorrow.